But I'm telling you what you're up against now. The standards of holiness have been broken down. They're not required now in church. I've gone to several funerals lately. And I'm telling you, ministers are so busy trying to impress their skills. That hundreds of people who would not go to church but will come to a funeral never hear that Jesus Christ saves. Never hear that we must repent if we plan to be delivered from this earthly tabernacle. Jesus said, Peter, if you love me, feed my people. Son, you can't make them. It's discipleship. If you really love, just preach what I told you. I left instructions.
Yes.
But now you don't want to preach this, you want to preach humanism. And it ain't nothing wrong with losing weight. Lose weight, protect your health, save your pancreas. You see, a lot of stuff you just want to do better about. Read the labels. I mean, you know, what do you take? Calories a day, 2,500? 3,000? Or is it 10,000? Everybody laughs because you know you're way over. But the truth of the matter is, we really counted our calories, we're probably up between 10, 15, 20,000. 2 or 3 Big Macs. What did I do last other Wednesday night? Ate 2 hamburgers. Caught myself working out walking. But I ain't stopped eating that. Everything that gets in my way. Because you got to be disciplined. No, the devil will trick you. The devil will tell you, you can do this. I still have to stop eating plates of ice cream. I'm still doing that. I can talk about me, but that's the name. Because ain't nobody that's doing that up here but me. I went to the ice box looking for food. Said, where are you at? At midnight, I don't know what everybody else is doing. First lady asleep, the boys is quiet up there. So this is when I make my move. Where are you at? I'm going to cook me something. That's what I'm saying. But I'm the one suffering with the wide belly. Y'all are hearing this. All the evidence is still here.
Yes, it is.
And you ain't got nothing on me. Those of you got 6 packs, ain't nothing on me. I got 12. I'm trying to help somebody. You know what I'm talking about. Y'all, we know the truth, right? I'm going to stop right there. But the Bible says now, if we get in Jesus and obey his command, see, that's power in loving the brethren. The Bible said, we pass from death unto life because we love the brother. We learn how to give ourselves. Doesn't it feel good when you give yourself to the same amount of people? When you feel like you helped somebody, or you consoled someone, or you made a child smile, you realize when you give to others, you're becoming more like Christ. And Jesus was totally unselfish. Always giving. Always taking the time to be concerned. Right now we're living in a world of no tolerance. We don't want to be bothered with much of anything. We don't want to be bothered with our children. Children don't want to be bothered with us. Better not be in no wheelchair. People walk past you in that thing. You know it's true, because they've gotten some motorbikes now.
Yeah.
You've got the motorized wheelchair. Some guy's mother passed, and he called and asked me, and said, you think I'm leaving with my mother passed? You think she like the motorized wheelchair? My mom said, mother, be on Interstate 10 trying to move out. No. No, she cannot have it. Mother be in Walmart. Said, mama, where are you going? You know your registration doesn't expire. But Jesus is trying to tell us today in Romans 12, I beseech you therefore, brother and mother, merciful of God, that you present your bodies. Why the body? Because the body becomes a personal identification. We can give money, and people give thousands of dollars to charity, but they don't give themselves. They can give other things away, furniture away, houses away, cars away. God says, all that's good, but can I get you? Can I get you to give yourself to me? Well, you can represent kingdom living in the earth. It takes effort, saints. That's what gets the world's attention when you were once out there with them. And they can see a change in your life. This ain't no hypocritical thing. It ain't worth it. It ain't worth hiding it if you really have it. But you know what I'm learning? God has to pierce our hearts. When he pierced our hearts, we're sold out for him. We're sold out to the point of simply saying, God, I want to show your glory. I want to show your glory to other people. And you've got to understand, it doesn't mean that you have to go around the world like some of us are doing in your everyday environment. Somebody needs direction. You just heard the news a few days ago when they arrested a young boy that had run through a community, cutting people with knives.